East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet. We're coming to you live from the CCRS studios. WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos radio show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos radio show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Welcome, everybody, and welcome, fellow patriots. Welcome once again to the Conservative Commandos radio show. I'm Rick Trader, live from the studios of the CCRS network here at WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia, and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM, FM, 24/7, Red State Talk Radio. We are everywhere. We're everywhere. And joining me today as my co-host is the Patriot from the Hoosier State, and that's my very good friend, J.D. Manier. J.D., welcome back to the Conservative Commandos radio show.
Hey, it's a joy and pleasure, privilege to be back with you for another great day.
Well, J.D., you're almost on this show as much as I am anymore, my friend. You're on Wednesday with Kevin and Monday with Kevin, Wednesday with me, so very intricate part. JD, something very interesting I thought I'd like to talk about, you know, if I could find it here. You know, we're always talking about crime and things like that, right? When it comes to gun crime and the situation, but I found this on the internet, and I'll take it as being true, but it's the causes of death in the United States for 2016. And mind you, we're only about halfway through 2016, and this list is through June 15th. But do you have any idea what the number one cause of death in the United States is?
I'm going to say heart-related.
Heart disease is actually number two. About 282,000 people have died of heart disease since the beginning of the year. But that's not the number one. Want to take another crack at it?
Highway fatalities?
Highway fatalities is, let me see. It's actually down the list. Highway fatalities is down the list. Accidents, unintentional accidents, are 62,000 deaths a year. But no, that is not the highest on the list. Drunk driving, 15,000 people have died so far this year from accidents because of drunk driving. But that is not number one. It's on our list.
How about old age?
Old age. Well, actually, old age isn't even listed. Is not even listed on this list. I guess once you get through all these other things, what don't get you, old age, well, but that's not on the list.
The Clintons?
Well, you might say close, but they're not on the list either.
Okay. You stumped me.
Well, actually, abortion. And our friend Mary Brockman has it right. Abortion is the number one cause of death in America so far in 2016. Over 500,000 babies, over 500,000 babies have had their lives ended because of abortion. Some might think gun deaths, murder by guns. Actually, it's way down the list. It's about, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. It's 21st on the list. Murder by gun. Oh, about 5,000 murder by gun. So when it comes to politicians who scream up and down, oh, you know, Black Lives Matter and Lives Matter and All Lives Matter. Well, what about the lives of the unborn? 500,000 babies have never had the opportunity to take their first breath because of abortion. Number two is heart disease. Number three is cancer. Number four, tobacco. Five, obesity. Six, medical errors. Seven, strokes. Lower respiratory infections, hospital-associated infection, alcohol, diabetes, and the list goes on. But murder by gun is number 21, 5,000 deaths. So anyway.
And you know what's so sad and sickening, and we told people on the campaign trail, 1,800 black babies are aborted every day in America. It's a huge preponderance, much greater than the representation demographically of blacks, but it's genocide. It's totally
genocide. So, JD, what's on your radar screen today?
Well, I'll kind of segue into what you were saying and ask you this ISIS kill list. Now, the FBI is reporting over 1,500 people they have, but they're not sharing very much with the American people. And I'm thinking, yeah, it'd be kind of nice if you knew you were on the list, wouldn't it?
I would think, you know, JD, I would think it is the duty of the FBI to let people know if they're on any kind of a kill list. And I'll tell you where I'm coming from. You remember The Sopranos, right, Tony, or JD?
Yes, sir.
All right, well, in The Sopranos, there was an episode where the FBI, in their wiretaps, found out that there was a hit on Tony Soprano, and that's why I called you Tony, on Tony Soprano. And they had to inform Tony of this threat to his life. Now, that is true. If the FBI or if the police know that there is a credible threat on your life, that it is incumbent upon them to let you know about that. So you got to figure out, why doesn't the FBI want to tell people about it? Could it be that they're under orders from this administration not to rock the boat because this is an election year?
Yep, absolutely. I mean, Kev and I Monday talked about it. Everything this administration has done is so suspect. I'm worried about the flooding and it killed 26 people. Talking about death again. Morbid subject, isn't it? But what was the Army Corps of Engineers doing up there in West Virginia, higher up where the locks and the dams are? I mean, I would, if I was in Congress, I'd say I want an investigation, because whenever there's deaths in America, I want to know, you know, what hand did the federal government have in on this, no matter what it is anymore. My gosh.
Well, deaths by drowning are not on this list that I have. Accidental deaths are, you know, accidental and unintentional death. That's a 62,000, so I guess those deaths can be part of that. Drug abuse actually has a higher rate of death than murder by gun. Murder by needle.
Sure.
Not hearing any calls for bans on needles, JD.
Suicide. What is that on your list?
Suicide. No, I don't see that on the list here. Hey, JD, let's take a break, and then we'll come back, and we'll talk about our guests and get into some other things. But you are listening to the Conservative Commandos radio show with JD Menier and Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos radio network at WNJC 1360 in Philly and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM, FM 24/7, Red State Talk Radio. Today's show is being brought to you by the First Amendment and protected by the Second. Don't go away, JD, and I'll be right back.
I really don't care. That's not the right.
The Conservative Commandos radio show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos radio network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos radio network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
We're David and Patty Berrickman of Wildflower Ridge Honey, beekeepers for 49 years. I want to tell you about a great survival and a multi-use product called Trail Rations. It is pure honey and a product of the USA. Trail Rations comes in a food-grade 12-ounce, very durable and reusable pouch, ready for immediate use or for long-term storage, because honey is the only food that never spoils. Honey is instant energy and goes right straight to your bloodstream. Honey is one of the best all-natural survival foods, natural sweetener right straight from Mother Nature. Honey is also antiviral, fungal, and bacterial. It's your first aid in a pouch. Carry one in your backpack or your bug-out bag. Find us on Facebook, Wildflower Ridge Honey, or call 765-641-9972, 765-641-9972.
You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Thank you for staying with us, and you are listening to the Conservative Commandos radio show with J.D. Manier and Rick Trader. And for rebroadcasts of our shows, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com. Or in the afternoons at 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net. At 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com. Or at midnight, redstatetalkradio.com. Or you can hear our show any time of the day from your telephone by calling 832-999-1199. You don't need an app. You don't need to download anything. You just need this number, 832-999-1199. So, J.D., who will we be talking with?
Oh, we've got a great show lineup today, Rick. I'll start out talking about 335. Jim Curry, the board member of the National Association of Chiefs of Police. And if anybody knows about crime, it's going to be him. And he's going to talk about this, the House Benghazi panel's report and how twisted by the media to protect Hillary Clinton this has been here in the last 24 hours. And we're all looking forward to this one. Lot to learn and respect his voice. And then, you know, at 4:05, then we have John Crane. And he's a candidate for the Indiana State House Senate. Indiana 24 is the district, comes from a very famous political family. A family, we'll talk more about it as we interview him, a family that was akin and people thought of as the conservative version of the Kennedy family. Mm-hmm. And looking forward to having John on the show.
Does that mean he's rich?
Go ahead.
Does that mean he's rich?
I know. I know John a little bit on this, but that side of the Kennedy family, that aspect is no.
Okay.
But boy, he had uncles and his father running for U.S. House, and he had a couple uncles in the U.S. House for a number of years. And, a great conservative political family, and looking forward to getting his views as the young generation of the Cranes, mm-hmm. Hoping to assume office here of leadership. 4:35, we got Rod Martin back to talk about last week. He was with so many, virtually 1,000 or more evangelicals when Trump hosted that event there in New York City, and he was one of the people there, and we had him on last month, and he looked forward to that meeting. He's going to talk also about Brexit, and Rod's a former three-term president of the NFRA. He's a philosopher, venture capitalist, tech guru, Christian leader, and his voice and words of wisdom have been so strong with me for the last number of years, and I think people are going to love to hear what he has to say.
All right, so we got a great show lined up. So what else is on your radar screen this day?
All right, here's something that frosts me more than just about anything. And Chris Wallace on the Sunday show, and he had Newt Gingrich on, Fox, the show that he does each Sunday. I mean, he did his best to be a Harry Reid. Remember Harry Reid said, this is on the Senate floor, all Obamacare horror stories are untrue. And so he basically stated, Donald Trump in his 50-point attack on Hillary, none of it's true. Channeling Harry Reid, it seemed like. And so I'm going to ask you, Rick, I've got the 50 facts on Hillary pulled up on my computer. Now, let me just ask you this one.
All right.
Four, millions of dollars from speeches the Clintons received to special interest.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that's true.
I think so, too. I think it's pretty verifiable also, isn't it?
I would think so, yeah. Be easy to find out. You just open her tax return.
Oh, my God.
Or has she offered to what do they call that? To give out her tax returns? You know how candidates challenge each other to...
Rick, excellent. Because they keep focusing on Trump on that very issue. But what about the Clintons? I think they've held off.
What about the Clintons?
They've got a whole fleet of tax attorneys that they use to shelter what they've been doing for years. And I remember just this last 48 hours, someone sent me an email picture, and it says, how could two people who have only been public servants all their lives, that's the only job they've had, how could they be worth now $200 million?
It's incredible.
Government jobs.
It's incredible, J.D., the fact that they produce nothing, okay? And yet... When did they leave the White House? In
98? Mm-hmm.
In 2000. They left the White House in 2000. Mm-hmm. And so in the 26 years that they, or the 16 years, that, my math's a little bad today. In the 16 years since they left the White House, and remember they said they left the White House penniless. That's why they had to loot the White House for furniture. Remember that, J.D.?
Yes.
And now they're worth millions. Millions. And what have they produced? What business have they run other than the Clinton Foundation?
As Rush Limbaugh calls it, the crime syndicate.
Okay.
A.K.A. the Clinton Foundation.
Right. But, I mean, it's not like they produce anything. It's not like they do any work. If they provide any goods or services... You know, they just go somewhere and spew their mouths off with a lot of wrong information, and companies and countries that want to be on the good side of the Clintons just bury them in money.
Yeah, 21 million, just over a couple of years' time, speaking to Wall Street tycoons. I mean, where do they go? Bill Clinton... I think 21 or 26 million he gets being on a board of the Clinton University that is so suspect. And
Clinton University? I mean, how many students go to the Clinton University?
I'm lying. It's a scam.
No kidding.
Pulling that daily.
No kidding. And people wonder about Trump University. At least maybe some people got some information out of the Trump University that would be a bit helpful to them, but what in the world does Clinton have to offer? Clinton University.
Yeah. I'm still looking at this report. You know, the 50 attacks. Well, yes or no, Rick? Number eight, trade deficit with China soared under the Clinton Secretary of State, period.
Oh, I would say that's probably a true.
Pretty verifiable, isn't it?
I would think so. I would think so. It's kind of like a no-brainer.
How about number 18? Among Clinton's victims was Ambassador Chris Stevens, who died in Benghazi.
Well, that's a given.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Chris Wallace, you're saying there's no truth in these statements. And he told the nation that this past Sunday. Ambassador Stevens issued hundreds of requests for security. That's all verifiable. He did it in writing. He did it over the phone. He did it. He probably tried carrier pigeon and prayer and all kinds of ways. But that's verifiable stuff. Number 21. Clinton lied about a video causing deaths of the four Americans in Benghazi.
Well, she even admitted to her daughter that attack had nothing to do with the video. That it was terrorist inspired. That was terrorism. And so it's
absolutely, Number 24, Clinton supported regime change in Syria. And what did that do? Well, it ended up in a bloody civil war, and it launched ISIS in the West. These are no-brainers, and they're all true. In November 25, Hillary, as Secretary of State, helped force out friendly regime in Egypt. Is that not true, or what?
Well, it was. She had a lot to do with that. So, you know, she also had to do with getting rid of Gaddafi in Libya. And Gaddafi was not a good guy. He was a bad guy. But Gaddafi was under control. And you see what has happened to Libya since Gaddafi has been murdered. I mean, it is chaos there. It's one of the reasons why there are four dead Americans, including our ambassador, because of the instability in Libya.
Number 29, Rick. On September 20th last year, CBS Face the Nation, Hillary said she supported a 550% increase in Syrian refugees.
Well, I would think that would be easy to verify. I mean, just Google it. Just Google it and you could probably find it in her own words.
Number 34. A top donor to the Clintons was brought on, and he had absolutely no credentials, to a sensitive national security board. Easy to check that out.
Well, there's so much. And this is a person that about half the country really believe is the best person to be our president. You know, that's the sad part, J.D., that there's so many people that think that she's the most qualified person in this country to be our next president. Hey, J.D., it's break time again, and you are listening to the Conservative Commandos radio show with J.D. Minear and Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos radio network at WNJC 1360 in Philadelphia and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM, FM 24/7, Red State Talk Radio. We are everywhere. We're everywhere. Don't go away. On the other side, we'll be speaking with Jim Corey, founder and CEO of Corey Associates, a Homeland Security, Public Safety, and Political Consulting firm. We're going to be talking about Benghazi. Be right back.
This is Rick Trader, host of the Conservative Commandos radio show.
And I'm John Forsyth, owner of WNJC Radio. Fellow patriots,
The Conservative Commandos radio show is for conservatives, about conservatives, and by conservatives.
We are patriots who want to take our country back from the likes of Barack Obama, Harry Reid, George Soros, and Nancy Pelosi.
But we can't keep up this fight without your critical support today. Can you help? Please go to www.helpccrs.com right now and make a donation by credit card or PayPal. That's www.helpccrs.com.
Our goal is to expose the liberal agenda and distortions. We are fighting to spread the truth about political issues, political leaders, and conservative issues and values.
Our hosts are not paid. In fact, we buy our own airtime, studio time, and pay our own expenses.
We created the show because we are trying to make a difference. So can you help the CCRS expose the truth in 2014 and beyond? Go to www.helpccrs.com.
Help keep the Conservative Commandos radio show on the air by going to www.helpccrs.com and make a donation today to return our country to the conservative roots created by our founding fathers.
9/11. It's a day that will go down in our history as the most horrific and destructive scene ever to happen on American soil. It will also be, for most Americans who witnessed it either up close or simply watched in horror on TV, America to participate in a national memorial I call the United Action of Prayer this coming 9/11 and every 9/11 from then on. United Action of Prayer is simply every American stopping whatever they are doing for 1 minute at precisely 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. to either observe 1 minute of silence or pray in memory for the 9/11 victims and their families, and perhaps a prayer of gratitude for living in a country where even 9/11 could not at all weaken the spirit of our great nation.
If you're in a crash and have little cash, come to AJ Auto Body. We handle insurance claims fast and repairs are guaranteed to last at AJ Auto Body. Come check us out and without a doubt, you'll be satisfied. That's AJ Auto Body, 1345 Delcy Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. Family owned and operated for 30 years. We are a fully licensed and insured auto repair facility located at 1345 Delcy Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. We are your friend in the business. So stop in for a free estimate or call us at 856-251-0096. Check us out on the web at www.ajautobody.net. That's where you'll find our specials, discounts, and coupons. For all your car needs, come to AJ Auto Body, located at 1345 Delcy Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. 856-251-0096.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number four, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos radio show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos radio network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos radio network every week. Day from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 a.m. or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com.
Check out our websites, conservativecommandosradionetwork.com and ccrn.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the Internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with J.D. Menear and Rick Trader. And for rebroadcasts, please check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or afternoons at 1 p.m. log on to roarradio.net, at 9 p.m. highplainsdailynews.com, or at midnight redstatetalkradio.com. And you can hear our show and all the shows that are associated with the Conservative Commandos Radio Network here at WNJC 1360 from your telephone by calling 832-999-1199. J.D. Menear, we have our first guest with this. We please make the introduction.
Well, Jim Curry is a board member of the National Association of Chiefs of Police. He's a columnist and a contributor to nationally syndicated talk radio program. He served as director of security for several major organizations. He served on the National Drug Task Force and trained police officers and security officers throughout the country. Welcome to the Conservative Commando Radio Show, Jim.
Well, thank you. Thanks for having me on.
Well, suffice to say, you know crime when you see it. And
I hope so.
I just got to admit, this broke for me, this story, late yesterday, and I've never heard Sean Hannity as angry in 20 years as I heard him last night talking about this stuff. The protection they're trying to give Hillary as they totally obfuscate the House Benghazi report. And I want you to take it away from there.
Oh, yeah. I thought it was disgusting, the reception that this report got. There was a lot of information that a lot of Americans didn't know about. For the media to say that there was nothing new, how do they know? There was nothing new. They did not read it. There was no way that they read it in the time, from the time it was released to the time they started reporting on it. So obviously, that was the theme or the narrative that they were going to go with. That there was nothing new. That Hillary Clinton, or as I call her, Hillary Caligula, didn't have anything to do with the Benghazi debacle, that President Obama and his administration had nothing to do. They blamed the military. They turned around and they blamed the military. For example, they talked about the fact that the Marines that were supposedly going to be deployed to Benghazi to save these people, they had to change their uniforms four times. In other words, somebody said they're going to go in uniform, and someone told them, no, you're not going in uniform, you're going in civvies. Then they had to change back into the uniform, and then they had to change out of the uniform. Yeah. Where did those orders come from? That doesn't sound like the orders that an officer in the Marines would give. That sounds like an order that Obama would give. That sounds like an order that Hillary Clinton would give, or Leon Panetta, or one of those clowns. So there is a lot in this report, and I've looked at the report, and there's a lot in it. The fact that they were lying to the American people should be enough to cast doubt on anything that these people tell us. For example, today, you know, they're talking about Turkey, and you had the other liar, John Kerry, saying that this was proof that ISIS is on the decline. How is that proof? You know, they attacked an airport. That's proof that they're on decline. I hope they don't show that they're on decline here in the United States, because then we're going to have some big problems.
Yeah, I heard Rush Limbaugh say earlier today, okay, if they're losing, you know, God help us if they ever win.
But this stuff is being shoved down the throats of the American people constantly. You have Hillary Clinton, the worst liar that I've ever seen in my entire... She lies about things that aren't even necessary to lie about. And it goes back to the day she was in the White House. I'll never forget when I had visited once the White House. I had to go to a meeting there. And after that, when the Clintons came in, I remember one of the uniformed Secret Service agents had called me in New York. I was working in New York at the time, and asked me if I knew of any law enforcement jobs in the New York metropolitan area, or maybe a security job with a major corporation. If I heard of anything, he said, I have to get out of this White House. And now we have another guy, another uniformed Secret Service agent, who wrote a book. I don't think anybody from the mainstream media has invited this guy onto their show, because he had a lot of stories to tell about Hillary Clinton and about how she operates. And so, you know, I'm not surprised that she would lie to this day. She's lying now. She said that she never told the family members of the Benghazi, those who were killed in Benghazi, that she never told them that she blamed the video for it. She said she always told them it was terrorists and that they would get the terrorists. Well, that makes them all liars. I've also interviewed, in fact, I've become friends with Ambassador Chris Stevens, his ex-fiancée. She's an actress, a French actress. They had met in 1994 in Europe, and she believes that Hillary Clinton is the biggest liar to come down the pike in years. And she believes that Hillary Clinton allowed those men to be left behind to die on purpose. And the reason was that they were running guns. That's what the CIA was doing there. Nobody seems to ask the questions. What were the CIA, what were they doing in the CIA in Benghazi? They were separate from, they weren't part of the consulate. They had their own operation going on. In fact, the security people were CIA security people who were contracted by the CIA security, not for the consulate. The CIA security people actually disobeyed orders and went to the consulate because they weren't about to let Americans get killed. And the fact is that they were running guns from Benghazi. They were collecting the guns that were left behind by Gaddafi's military, and shipping those guns to ISIS. Well, at that time they were being called the rebels, but they were being shipped to ISIS in Syria, and that's the truth. That's the truth. In fact, there were emails that verified that, and yet Clinton and Obama. We're being told,
Jim,
by the media.
Jim, we got a break on you right now because of a commercial time. But please hold that thought. We'll come back and talk some more. and we are coming to you live. This is J.D. Manier and Rick Trader, our host of the Concerted Commando Radio Show, and coming to you live from WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia, around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcast, Talkstream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, Red State Talk Radio, and AM/FM 24/7.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
We're David and Patty Berrickman of Wildflower Ridge Honey, beekeepers for 49 years. I want to tell you about a great survival and a multi-use product called Trail Rations. It is pure honey and a product of the USA. Trail Rations comes in a food-grade 12-ounce, very durable and reusable pouch, ready for immediate use or for long-term storage, because honey is the only food that never spoils. Honey is instant energy and goes right straight to your bloodstream. Honey is one of the best all-natural survival foods, natural sweetener right straight from Mother Nature. Honey is also antiviral, fungal, and bacterial. It's your first aid in a pouch. Carry one in your backpack or your bug-out bag. Find us on Facebook, Wildflower Ridge Honey, or call 765-641-9972, 765-641-9972.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with J.D. Manier and yours truly, Rick Trader. For rebroadcasts of our show, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or in the afternoon at 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net, at 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com, or at midnight, log on to redstatetalkradio.com. Our guest this segment is Jim Corey. Jim is the founder and CEO of Corey Associates, a homeland security public safety and political consulting firm. And we're discussing an article that Jim has written, House Benghazi Panel's Report Twisted by Media to Protect Hillary Clinton. Jim, thanks for holding through that break. We appreciate your time.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Jim, I was shocked and appalled watching the TV the other night when they started to talk about this report coming out. Perked my ears up. But when they said that the military was to blame and left it at that. The military is to blame, Jim. That's what the media is reporting.
Yeah, that's what they reported, and I blame those people, upper echelon people, that are working for Obama. None of them measure up to a General George Patton. Can you imagine General George Patton? Can you imagine him behaving the way they do, covering up for this? I call him an imposter. Mm-hmm. I always. A lot of my friends, they even get taken aback when I call them in lieu of a president, we have Barack Obama. Yeah. The fact is that he is not a leader, and these guys, these generals, these admirals, are handpicked because they are compliant with him in every way. In fact, he lies, and they cover it up.
Well, Jim, this was what Ambassador Stevens was doing over there was, as you reported, had to do with gun running. This was an operation coming out of the State Department. The pleas for help was going back to the State Department from our Ambassador Stevens there. So how are they spinning this that it is the military to blame? It is the administration and the State Department that told the military to stand down. Who in the media or from the media or former media is coming out and saying, whoa, wait a minute, this is not how it went down?
Well, you know, they've been, you know, this, with all due respect to Trey Gowdy, he was in over his head, all right? He is not as powerful as people think he is. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he practically begged the president to answer a simple 15 question, and the president refused. All right? This is the president that finds time to pal around with his Hollywood friend, to go to Martha's Vineyard to play golf, to give a speech about an American being beheaded, if you remember that, American journalist being beheaded, and then going to play golf. This is the guy who couldn't find time to answer 15 questions that were posed to him about Benghazi. We still don't know where he was. He wasn't in the war room because now we know that Hillary was the senior person.
Well, we don't know where he was at. Nobody knows where he is at from 6 hours, from 5:30 to 11:30. And the next day he was on a plane to Las Vegas. Nobody knows where he was at during that time, maybe except for Reggie Love, his personal assistant in the White House. Maybe Reggie Love knows where he was, but no one else does.
No, you don't. And also, you know, they were saying there was no way we could have gotten help to them. Well, anyone who saw the movie saw how hard they tried. Mm-hmm. There were five or six former special forces were working as CIA contractors in Tripoli. They managed to get there. In fact, one of those
was Chris Pronto, who's been a guest on the show.
Well, he probably told you the whole story.
He says how they were told to stand down, and finally they said, BS on this. We're going to go to try to save American lives.
Well, they were told, listen, we're the CIA. You're just security guards. You don't say anything. You don't do anything. And that was the way the CIA treated them. Until the CIA was under attack, all of a sudden, these guys were heroes to them.
Hey, Jim, another question. House Select Committee, the House Select Committee. Now, to me, that sounds like something that would have some teeth. I remember the House Select Committee that investigated Watergate that led up to the near impeachment and the resignation of the President of the United States. Does this House Select Committee have any teeth? Are there going to be any ramifications? Or is that it? Is this it, Jim?
You know, Nancy Pelosi picked the Democrats that she knew would stonewall, would backstab. You know, the people that were on that committee, especially Elijah Cummings. Elijah Cummings should be investigated. Never mind an investigator. He should be. He's one who should be investigated. He's the one who really got Lois Lerner and her cohorts in the IRS to go after conservatives and conservative groups and conservative organizations. He's the one that did it. Him and John McCain, I call him the king of the rhinos, John McCain. Yeah, he's the one that should be investigated into how come the IRS singled out so many conservative groups, Tea Party groups, and left the left-wing groups alone. Now, one of Soros' groups were investigated, in spite of the fact we don't know how they were being funded. We don't know how he was getting the money to fund, for example, Occupy Wall Street, and how he funds groups like Black Lives Matter and those type of groups. You never hear the IRS investigating them, mm-hmm. but a conservative group that's against abortion, right away they're investigating and they're leaking information to the media about these groups. Now, that's Elijah Cummings, and they appointed him to be the senior Democrat on that committee, and his job was to stop the investigation.
Jim, you're right. It was never about finding out the truth. It was all about protecting this administration, the Democrat Party. Hey, Jim, in conclusion, because we only have a couple of minutes, do you see this as hurting Hillary Clinton? Now, forget Barack Obama. That's water over the dam. Okay, but do you see this as hurting Hillary Clinton, or are the public just numb to this by now?
You know, the public, for some reason, they're willing to accept anything from this woman because she promises them the world. You know, that you would think by now people would learn. For example, African Americans, except for a few that I know who are conservatives, most of them, they believe that this woman's going to help them. And she has no intention of helping anyone but herself. First of all, I hope the FBI has better luck than Trey Gowdy. Because as far as I could see, just on what I know, this woman should be indicted. She should be imprisoned, prosecuted and imprisoned.
For what? For what, Jim? Because of the Benghazi disaster, or because of her email scandals, or the Clinton Foundation? I mean, you've got a lot to pick from there, Jim.
Oh yeah, the Clinton Foundation. You're talking about an organized crime group that launders money routinely, and she gets away with it.
Hey, Jim, we got to run real quick, but I wanted to give you an opportunity to tell our audience how they could follow your work.
Well, they could write to me at Cop Magazine, COP Magazine, all one word, at AOL.com, and they can get our free newsletter.
All right, and your website?
Oh, the website is Conservative Base, all one word, Conservative Base, BASE, at conservativebase.com.
Hey, J.D. Menier, we got about 1 minute left with Jim. Final question?
Well, what do you think of her deferring to the Libyan government? You got people dying. There's 8 hours this thing takes over. And she's telling the Marines, she's telling all the military folks, because it sounds like Obama is gone for 8 hours on 9/11, the anniversary of 9/11. You can't find where the president is on the anniversary of 9/11, but she keeps deferring to Libya while our people are being killed.
Yeah, she also said, if you remember, she also said nobody was killed in Libya in one of her speeches. And nobody said anything in the media about it. I mean, conservative talk radio said something about it. Glenn Beck said something about it. But the media just let it slide. NBC, ABC, CBS, they're all in the tank for this woman. I mean, it's just unbelievable what they have done on behalf of this candidate. And Yeah, I feel sorry for Donald Trump. He's got to fight.
No, I feel sorry for the country.
Republicans and the media.
Jim, I feel sorry for the country, but we got to run. We got to go. Jim, I want to. Jim Corey, President and CEO of Corey Associates, I want to thank you so much for joining us here on the Conservative Commandos radio show. Take care. God bless. And you are listening to the Conservative Commandos with J.D. Minear and Rick Trader, coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network at WNJC 1360 in Philadelphia and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, AM/FM 24/7, RedStateTalkRadio.com. Don't go away. On the other side, we're going to be speaking with John Crane. He is a candidate for Senate in Indiana. We'll be right back. I really don't care. That's my prerogative.
They say I'm nasty, but I... This is Rick Trader, host of the Conservative Commandos radio show.
And I'm John Forsyth, owner of WNJC Radio. Fellow patriots, the Conservative Commandos radio show is for conservatives, about conservatives, and by conservatives.
We are patriots who want to take our country back from the likes of Barack Obama, Harry Reid, George Soros, and Nancy Pelosi.
But we can't keep up this fight without your critical support today. Can you help? Please go to www.helpccrs.com right now and make a donation by credit card or PayPal. That's www.helpccrs.com.
Our goal is to expose the liberal agenda and distortions.
We are fighting to spread the truth about political issues, political leaders, and conservative issues and values.
Our hosts are not paid. In fact, we buy our own airtime, studio time, and pay our own expenses.
We created the show because we are trying to make a difference. So can you help the CCRS expose the truth in 2014 and beyond? Go to www.helpccrs.com.
Help keep the Conservative Commandos radio show on the air by going to www.helpccrs.com and make a donation today to return our country to the conservative roots created by our founding fathers.
9/11. It's a day that will go down in our history as the most horrific and destructive scene ever to happen on American soil. It will also be, for most Americans who witnessed it either up close or simply watched in horror on TV, America to participate in a national memorial I call the United Action of Prayer this coming 9/11 and every 9/11 from then on. United Action of Prayer is simply every American stopping whatever they are doing for 1 minute at precisely 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. to either observe 1 minute of silence or pray in memory for the 9/11 victims and their families, and perhaps a prayer of gratitude for living in a country where even 9/11 could not at all weaken the spirit of our great nation.
If you're in a crash and have little cash, come to AJ Auto Body. We handle insurance claims fast and repairs are guaranteed to last at AJ Auto Body. Come check us out and without a doubt, you'll be satisfied. That's AJ Auto Body, 1345 Delcy Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. Family owned and operated for 30 years. We are a fully licensed and insured auto repair facility located at 1345 Delcy Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. We are your friend in the business. So stop in for a free estimate or call us at 856-251-0096. Check us out on the web at www.ajautobody.net. That's where you'll find our specials, discounts, and coupons. For all your car needs, come to AJ Auto Body, located at 1345 Delcy Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. 856-251-0096.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number four, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, www.ccrsnetwork.com and www.ccrshow.com. Or at 1 p.m., log on to www.roarradio.net. And at 9 p.m., log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And at midnight, you can log on to redstatetalkradio.com. You can listen to Conservative Commanders Radio Show from your phone by dialing 832-999-1199. Our next guest, John Crane, is a respected educator and cultural thought leader who speaks and teaches on university campuses, on TV and in radio, and in churches and other venues across the country and around the world. He regularly navigates the intersection between timeless truths and cultural trends. John is currently running as the GOP nominee for Indiana Senate District 24, and he comes from a distinguished conservative political family that included his Uncle Phil, who ran for president against Ronald Reagan and served as a U.S. House rep from Illinois for over 25 years. Another uncle served multiple terms in Congress, and his dad ran three times for the U.S. House of Representatives in Indiana. His grandfather was a widely syndicated conservative newspaper columnist for 60 years, and even wrote speeches for Calvin Coolidge. Welcome to the Conservative Commander Radio Show, John.
Hey, it's good to be with you. Glad to be here.
You were only one of two candidates out of 125 statehouse races to defeat an incumbent here in Indiana this primary season. Sentiment off the charts right now in favor of removing these establishment candidates. But it's a hard thing to do. I'd like you to comment on this political fact, John.
Yeah, absolutely. It was really a hard-fought primary, and as you know, taking on any incumbent is a tall task. I'm not naturally inclined to do that, but the incumbent in our area had taken some policy positions on fundamental things like traditional marriage and religious liberty and things that were not as conservative as they should have been. So that's what kind of got me in the race. And then as we were running, we were blessed to have a strong grassroots army of people and volunteers that helped us. And as you pointed out to your listeners, of the 125 legislative races in Indiana, there were only two incumbents in the entire state that got knocked off, and one was in the state house, and then the other was our opponent in the state senate. So we were very grateful for all the hard work that folks put in, and certainly we're glad for the victory.
John, you've studied and taught leadership skills to high school and college students. Can you give our listeners a little of your background in this endeavor and what you're doing currently in terms of inspiring our next generation of leaders?
Sure. About 6 or 7 years ago, we launched a leadership development program called the Sagamore Leadership Initiative here in Indiana. And the express mission of Sagamore is to equip next generation leaders to influence the culture for the good. And so essentially what we do is we identify high caliber high school and college age leaders, bring them together on a regular basis, and help them wrestle through not only why they believe what they believe, but more importantly, why a faith-based, conservative, philosophical worldview is so important in today's ever-changing times. And so we want to help them begin to develop cultural awareness so that they can pursue cultural engagement. And we do that through teaching. We do that through bringing high-caliber leaders and speakers to speak with the students. We do that through experiential opportunities that the students can have, all with the purpose long-term of helping those students find themselves at the strategic intersections of cultural influence. And so it really is a long-term goal that we're trying to pursue, and that is to really raise up a generation and a movement of solid, thoughtful, critically engaged leaders from here in Indiana. And we're really excited about beginning to see some of that bear fruit over these last 6 or 7 years.
Well, you come from a political family, John.
And that's right.
They were mentioned in the press at one time being the conservative equivalent of the Kennedy clan. You had two uncles in Congress, your dad.
That's right.
To be in the House of Representatives at the same time. Talk about the blessings and challenges of having grown up in that kind of politically charged environment.
Well, and you're right. I mean, there are both blessings and challenges. I would say there were more blessings than challenges, but for me, we have been really trained up since day one to recognize that we've been given God-given gifts and abilities, and that we have an obligation, you know, as the old adage says, to whom much is given, much is required. And combining that with, you know, as we continue to watch generation after generation, what the generational challenges are with a culture that's always shifting and changing, you know, we were taught to fight the good fight, and that there is a war out there, and not in a necessarily always a militaristic way, but certainly a war of ideas. And if we as the conservative leaders do not stand up and engage in the public square, then truth is not held sway. And so our family really has been oriented that way, been oriented towards using our God-given gifts in service to others. I have been extraordinarily blessed with the heritage that I've been given, both in my extended family and even in my immediate family, with such great role models of leaders that have done that across the board. And so even the things that I'm doing and the things that I've been doing even prior to sticking my foot in the political waters have all been ultimately grounded in that upbringing. And we just try to pass that on to the next generation and to our four kids. And of course, all the work we're doing with Sagamore and passing those things on to other families, because we know that we've all got to band together in this. So I just feel privileged to have been growing up in the Crane family. It's a blessing. It truly is.
And this may extend, we've got about 2 minutes left before our first break, and this could probably will extend into the second segment, but why did you choose to follow in your family conservative political footsteps, and then give us a vision of the kind of changes you'd like to see take place in 2017 here in our state and at the federal level? What do we need to be doing?
Yeah. Well, and I'll speak first prior to the break as to why I chose to pursue this. In some ways, I didn't choose it. Because of our family history, over the years, people have asked me and assumed that I was just going to get into politics at some point. And I, like so many people, have spent most of my life just being kind of a armchair political analyst. But this was different. I think given where things are in the culture, I think given the climate, I think given certain variables within our particular community and in the Senate district, there were a number of variables that came together in kind of a unique way that told me after prayerful consideration that this is something that God was calling me to do, and where God calls you, then he'll equip you. And so we just started down that path, and there are a lot of reasons why. We can get into that after the break, but I just see a lot of challenges that need to be addressed, and of course, doing nothing is not an option, so we're going to do what we can.
Well, yeah, and Lincoln said 150 years ago, let the people know the facts, and
that's
we'll
right.
be free. And I think we've had a couple earlier segments on the show talking about the distortions and obfuscations of Hillary, and this Benghazi report and, uh-huh. and Obama, but we got a break. Let's talk about that when we come back. And thank you for waiting on us, John. And
sure.
We're coming to you live. This is JD and our host, Rick Trader, with the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. And we're in the studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia, and around the world on the internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, Red State Talk Radio, and AM FM 24/7.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
We're David and Patty Berrickman of Wildflower Ridge Honey, beekeepers for 49 years. I want to tell you about a great survival and a multi-use product called Trail Rations. It is pure honey and a product of the USA. Trail Rations comes in a food-grade 12-ounce, very durable and reusable pouch, ready for immediate use or for long-term storage, because honey is the only food that never spoils. Honey is instant energy and goes right straight to your bloodstream. Honey is one of the best all-natural survival foods, natural sweetener right straight from Mother Nature. Honey is also antiviral, fungal, and bacterial. It's your first aid in a pouch. Carry one in your backpack or your bug-out bag. Find us on Facebook, Wildflower Ridge Honey, or call 765-641-9972, 765-641-9972.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, www.ccrsnetwork.com. and www.ccrshow.com. We're at 1 p.m. You can log on to www.roarradio.net. At 9 p.m. in the evening, log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And at midnight, you can log on to redstatetalkradio.com. Now you can listen to Concerted Commandos Radio anywhere from your phone just by dialing 832-999-1199. Our guest, John Crane, is a GOP candidate for the Indiana State Senate 24th District, District number 24, and we want to welcome you back, John.
Thank you.
Hey, let's pick right up where we left off, and your political vision. What you'd like to see as a young leader up there in the state?
Yeah. Well, you know, I think it's interesting, and I think our state is just symptomatic of a larger issue in the nation, and that a couple things. Number one, I think we have lost sight of who we are as Republicans and as conservatives. We live in a culture that is resistant to labels and so forth. And so in the midst of diminishing labels, we begin to redefine things. And so I think it would be incumbent upon those on the right side of the political aisle to become very clear about where we stand and why. For example, in our state, at the state convention, there was a push again this year to take the definition of marriage, traditional marriage between a man and a woman, out of the Republican platform. And that has been part of the Republican platform for generations. And so I think it's important to understand who we are. But secondly, and relatedly, I think it's also important, once we understand who we are or get realigned with who we are, that we have the moral and political courage and will to stand by where, you know, our philosophical positions are. Because presumably we take those philosophical positions because they're well-grounded in truth, they're well-grounded in a certain ethical and moral framework. They're well-grounded in the practical realities of applying that philosophy. We hold to conservatism, not only because we believe it's true, but because it works in the lives of real people. And so I think we should be able to unapologetically defend that without fearing what the media is going to say or what the left's going to say. But that assumes that we've done the hard work of educating ourselves on why we believe what we believe. So I think there's a lot of room for that, because certainly some of the most volatile issues and emotionally charged issues, you know, many of these social issues and so forth, they're not going away. And so we on the right better figure out what our thoughtful response is to many of these issues so that we can not only be reacting, but we can be proactive in leading the way down the path of truth.
Well, and like here in Indiana, the constitutionality, some of these bills are getting cobbled together, attacking Christian rights and our ability to live out the Christian life in the workplace. And
that's right.
This is unconstitutional, some of the stuff they've cobbled together to try to do the politically correct thing. Talk about that.
That's right. That's exactly right. In fact, you know, as you know, in the state of Indiana over the last two or three legislative cycles. First, it was defining marriage between a man and a woman, what we refer to here in Indiana as the marriage amendment. We went through that whole process, and the process is still technically alive, but it, by all practical measures, was a defeat. And then last year in 2015 was the Religious Freedom Restoration Act, which became a national news story. And typically, if there's a national news story coming out of Indiana that's not related to race weekend, it's probably a negative. And so all of a sudden, we came into a national spotlight on whether or not we should protect, which the irony of the Religious Freedom Restoration Act is it's intended to strengthen the First Amendment. And in theory, we shouldn't need a bill because we have the First Amendment. But given the fact that we've allowed the culture and many of those on the progressive side of the aisle to continue to dilute the value of religious liberty, we find ourselves in a real quandary. And then, of course, this year, there was a push to advance sexual orientation and gender identity and make it part of the protected class here in Indiana. And at that point, for many of the Republicans, that was a bridge too far, so it never made it out of committee. But those issues are not going away. And in fact, one of the things that I think folks need to understand is because, you know, we live in a culture where the value of religion is being diminished. And in fact, with the millennial generation, there is a rise of folks that are self-proclaimed nuns, N-O-N-E-S. And that category is basically for those that do not adhere to any religious affiliation per se. And so that's a big story, that we're becoming less religious. Well, my response to some of those folks and my friends on that side of the issue is, just because religion doesn't matter to you, or just because religious liberty doesn't matter to you, doesn't mean it doesn't matter. And so we've got to help people understand that as where religious liberty pertains specifically to citizens who are people of faith, rights of conscience applies to everybody, including those that are religious or non-religious. Those fundamental core convictions that every person has, and that is the very cornerstone of how America was founded. We lose that, and we have sown the seeds of our own eventual destruction. And so we have to be very, very vigilant about that.
John, take a few moments then to speak about your Christian faith and how it motivates you to be the best leader possible.
Well, and you hit right on it, J.D. My Christian faith is what informs everything else I do. I firmly adhere to an evangelical Christian worldview. I am a biblical Christian and do the best I can to read and interpret Scripture as Scripture is intended to be interpreted, and therefore live my life accordingly, raise my family accordingly. And in fact, that's one of the things that we teach to our Sagamore leaders, is to help them understand that your faith or your deeply held beliefs cannot be compartmentalized. I can't be simply a Christian on Sundays or Wednesdays or when I'm with my Christian small group, or maybe I attend my Christian homeschool group or Christian school. Christianity as a worldview, by definition, applies to everything that we do. And so there's been this unintentional reinforcement in the church over generations of creating a hierarchy, that you have those who are in what we call full-time Christian ministry, and by that we refer to the international missionaries, the pastors, and maybe those that are in full-time nonprofit work. Well, that represents a certain minority segment of the church population, and so everybody else is sitting there going, well, what about me? I'm a teacher, or I'm an IT guy, or I'm a businessman, or I'm a lawyer, or I'm a politician. And so what we need to help people understand is that we're all missionaries. We all have a mission. The question simply is, what's your mission field? And so to me, even this political endeavor, it is merely an extension of my approach to life. And that is that God's called us all to be on mission, and that is to love God and to love people, and to help people learn to love God and to adhere to His truth, because it's going to provide the best life for us to live. And as long as I'm on mission, then the specific context becomes less important. And then I just have to figure out, how do I apply that mission to whatever context it is that God's called me? And so that's really my intent and purpose. And I'm not intending to browbeat people. I think sometimes there is this false assumption by those that are outside conservative Christianity that, you know, like, for example, when I get elected, you know, I think people are going to assume I'm ready to just go down to the state house and burn the place down, and that's not constructive, you know, that's not valuable, and I don't think that's the way Jesus would do it. I think we need to sit down with people, we need to talk, we need to listen, we need to be able to come together where we can agree, we need to negotiate on negotiables, but we also need to hold fast on non-negotiables, and there certainly are non-negotiables that we need to have the moral and the courage, really, and the will to be able to stand strong on. But I think we can do that in a very reasonable and thoughtful way. So my
John, we're coming up against the end of our interview, and boy, it's been great having you on the show. And the key is a rock solid voting record, and I think you will amass that. Let's go ahead and let our listeners support you and how they can do that and stay in touch.
Great. I appreciate that. The biggest thing that I'm passionate about is this next generation leadership development. Folks can find out more information about what we're doing at sagamoreleadership.org. That's SAGAMORE leadership.org. And, of course, we always could use financial support, prayers, and support in other ways to help us raise up next-generation leaders. And then, of course, our campaign always needs support as well for us to finish what we started in the spring. And so for anybody that's interested in supporting us on that front, it's votecrane.com. And so we just welcome fellow conservatives and people of faith to be a part of the movement to really be on mission for the things that we all care about and believe in.
It's been great having you on the show, the Conservative Commander Radio Show with John Crane. And God bless, John. We'll look forward to hearing from you here this fall as well. And if you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our websites, www.ccrsnetwork.com and www.ccrshow.com. And at 1 p.m., log on to www.roarradio.net. At 9 p.m., log on to highplainsdailynews.com. And at 12 midnight, log on to redstatetalkradio.com. Now you can listen to the Conservative Commando Radio Show any place, anytime by calling and dialing 832-999-1199.
This is Rick Trader, host of the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
And I'm John Forsyth, owner of WNJC Radio. Fellow patriots, the Conservative Commandos Radio Show is for conservatives, about conservatives, and by conservatives.
We are patriots who want to take our country back from the likes of Barack Obama, Harry Reid, George Soros, and Nancy Pelosi.
But we can't keep up this fight without your critical support today. Can you help? Please go to www.helpccrs.com right now and make a donation by credit card or PayPal. That's www.helpccrs.com.
Our goal is to expose the liberal agenda and distortions.
We are fighting to spread the truth about political issues, political leaders, and conservative issues and values.
Our hosts are not paid. In fact, we buy our own airtime, studio time, and pay our own expenses.
We created the show because we are trying to make a difference. So can you help the CCRS expose the truth in 2014 and beyond? Go to www.helpccrs.com.
Help keep the Conservative Commandos Radio Show on the air by going to www.helpccrs.com and make a donation today to return our country to the conservative roots created by our founding fathers.
9/11. It's a day that will go down in our history as the most horrific and destructive scene ever to happen on American soil. It will also be, for most Americans who witnessed it either up close or simply watched in horror on TV, America to participate in a national memorial I call the United Action of Prayer this coming 9/11 and every 9/11 from then on. United Action of Prayer is simply every American stopping whatever they are doing for 1 minute at precisely 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. to either observe 1 minute of silence or pray in memory for the 9/11 victims and their families, and perhaps a prayer of gratitude for living in a country where even 9/11 could not at all weaken the spirit of our great nation.
If you're in a crash and have little cash, come to AJ Auto Body. We handle insurance claims fast and repairs are guaranteed to last at AJ Auto Body. Come check us out and without a doubt, you'll be satisfied. That's AJ Auto Body, 1345 Delsey Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. Family owned and operated for 30 years. We are a fully licensed and insured auto repair facility located at 1345 Delsey Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. We are your friend in the business. So stop in for a free estimate or call us at 856-251-0096. Check us out on the web at www.ajautobody.net. That's where you'll find our specials, discounts, and coupons. For all your car needs, come to AJ Auto Body, located at 1345 Delsey Drive in Deptford, New Jersey. 856-251-0096.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS4automation.com. That's PCS, the number 4, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
You are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with J.D. Minear and Rick Trader. And we're coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. If you'd like to hear a rebroadcast of our shows, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or afternoons at 1 p.m., log on to roarradio.net, at 9 p.m., highplainsdailynews.com, or at midnight, please log on to redstatetalkradio.com, or you can hear our show any time of the day by calling 832-999-1199. J.D., we have our next guest with us, and will you please make that introduction?
Well, Rod Martin is the founder and CEO of the Martin Organization. The technology entrepreneur, he's a futurist, head fund manager, thought leader, and conservative activist from Destin, Florida. Fox Business News calls him a tech guru. Britain's Guardian labels him a philosopher capitalist. And he addressed audiences on four continents, and he's written extensively for publications such as Forbes, Human Events, Fortune, and FoxNews.com. Rod has been recognized as one of America's leading experts on the conjunction of technology and politics. And he formerly served as policy director to Governor Mike Huckabee and an aide to senior congressional leader John Paul Hammersmith. And he was a former three-term president of the NFRA. Welcome, my good friend, Rod Martin.
Hey, it's good to be here.
Rod, I got to pause here because my guest that we just spoke prior to you actually studied a little bit of theology at Oxford, and I know you studied at Cambridge. So with that, I'm eager to hear about the Trump meeting, but can you kind of give us your thoughts on Brexit right now?
Well, Brexit's just wonderful, and it just boggles my mind to hear all these people talking about the economic costs. what on earth is the cost of freedom? What are they thinking? And by this logic that we keep getting pounded with day in and day out, you would absolutely have to oppose the American Revolution, which caused all manner of inflation and recession and everything under the sun here. And as you can see, the American experiment completely failed. Because of our Amerixit, we obviously just died and all fell into the sea 10 years later. I mean, it's just mind-boggling. But I'm very, very proud of what they did. You'll notice the markets have rebounded just fine. There's very real possibility that the pound will reach parity for a little while. I wouldn't worry about that at all. Might short it a little bit, but it'll come back. What is important is that the British have reclaimed their national heritage and identity and liberty. And it's a wonderful thing. It's a wake-up call to Brussels. You already see multiple countries on the continent talking about their own referenda. This is a very positive development for all involved. And I just want to see, as Margaret Thatcher wanted to see, Britain join NAFTA, and we can create an Atlantic free trade area without all of the political trappings and unelected bureaucrats making laws for us. That would be truly awesome.
Well, that's excellent, Rod. And you know, in 2017, and they're going to bring a new prime minister in the UK as well. Cameron's stepping down, but we could, let's just pray that, and I want you to comment, let's try to get another Thatcher Reagan style alliance rebuilt here in America. I mean, after all, he took out the bust, Obama did, of Winston Churchill from the White House.
Well, I'll be very shocked if Boris doesn't end up prime minister, and Boris Johnson is just wonderful. He is everything I think that you're hoping for. And he is absolutely the right man to lead England into the future.
Once again, the economics of this, we're being just fed a whole lot of stuff that just isn't going to happen, and it's not true. The chicken littles were all over the place on this one, and remind the folks here just how big an economy UK has.
Well, yeah. I mean, this is ludicrous on its face. Britain has the fifth largest economy in the world by itself. The Chicken Littles have a very good reason to be Chicken Little-y. They need Britain to pay the bills for all the deadbeat countries that make up most of the European Union. Those guys need subsidies, and somebody has to pay them. So if Britain leaves, that puts Berlin in a bad position, that puts Paris in a bad position. You know, the producers will have to further subsidize the consumers, and that's the real issue. In any case, Britain by itself, as I said, fifth largest economy in the world, absolutely the best military in Europe, except for Russia, absolutely the best military in the European Union. They have nukes, for heaven's sake. They are a true global power, and nobody seems to be pointing out, and I have to count myself in that. I wrote about this the other day, as you know. But they are a veto-wielding permanent Security Council member. They're the real deal. Now, they aren't what they were when they ruled India and Australia and half the world, but they are a first-rank power. They don't need the EU.
Yeah, just for people to know, Russia is the 10th largest economy. So now you got UK is the fifth. And
And actually, just to be clear, the state of Florida is not much smaller than Russia's economy. The state of Texas is significantly bigger than Russia's economy. People don't get these numbers, and Britain towers over all of this. Now, Germany's fourth, to be fair, and if you count the fact that they're recreating the German Empire through the EU, maybe they're even bigger than that. But America by itself, just the United States, is bigger economically than all 28 countries in the EU put together. And if you added Britain to NAFTA, so you subtract its economy from the EU and add it to NAFTA, now we're 50% larger economically as a trade area, just Britain, Canada, America, Mexico. So what possible benefit is there to being in this supposed trade area that in fact is a nascent super state? Again, a government entirely made up of unaccountable, unelected bureaucrats in a foreign country, mostly from foreign countries, dictating every jot and tittle of British life today without any possibility of recourse, versus being a member of a free trade area with us where you get to make all your own laws and keep your own currency. I mean, this is a no-brainer to me.
Rod, that's so well said, and I've got to put you on hold because we're coming up against a hard commercial break, but we want to continue and let you talk more about that Trump meeting last week. And this is J.D. and Rick Trader coming to you live from the Concerted Commander Radio Network studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia, and around the world on the Internet with American Patriots Broadcasting, TalkStream Live, SHR Media, K98 Talk, iHeartRadio, Red State Talk Radio, and AM-FM 24/7.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
David and Patty Berrickman of Wildflower Ridge Honey, beekeepers for 49 years. I want to tell you about a great survival and a multi-use product called Trail Rations. It is pure honey and a product of the USA. Trail Rations comes in a food-grade 12-ounce, very durable and reusable pouch, ready for immediate use or for long-term storage, because honey is the only food that never spoils. Honey is instant energy and goes right straight to your bloodstream. Honey is one of the best all-natural survival foods, natural sweetener right straight from Mother Nature. Honey is also antiviral, fungal, and bacterial. It's your first aid in a pouch. Carry one in your backpack or your bug-out bag. Find us on Facebook, Wildflower Ridge Honey, or call 765-641-9972, 765-641-9972.
You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with J.D. Manier and yours truly, Rick Trader. Our guest this segment is Rob Martin. He's the founder and CEO of the Martin Organization, and he's also past president for the National Association of Republican Assemblies. Rod, thanks for holding through that break. We appreciate your time. Rob, I know J.D. wants to get into and talk with you about the meeting that you had last week with Donald Trump. But first of all, you know, this idea of the United States of Europe, I think, was destined to fail. I think the experiment called the United States of America was a very exceptional one. In fact, we had a very bloody civil war to cement it. But it seems like wherever you have had states that try to make a country, for instance, the Soviet Union or Iraq or Czechoslovakia or Yugoslavia, they've all met with failures. So why would anyone think that a United States of Europe, with all its diversities, with all its different languages, would even work in the first place?
Well, you know, you left out one example that really did work that illustrates your point, and that's Germany. Germany was a collection, you know, when Napoleon was running around Europe with his army, there were over 300 independent states in what is today Germany, and they melded together really well. Italy, actually, same thing in the 1860s. Why? Well, to start with, they all spoke the same language. They all shared more or less the same culture. They all had basically the same aspirations. They're all pointing in the same direction. Now, what on earth does Northern Ireland have to do with Greece? Or, you know, it's just, it's irrational. There are too many things that don't fit together well there. It's sort of like me getting married to a tree. I might like the tree, but that's not going to be a good match. So, you know, Europe needs a free trade area. That's great. They can have that. They do have that. Europe needs a common defense. We've demonstrated that reasonably clearly, but oh wait, we have that. It's called NATO, and that's not going away.
Mm-hmm.
So they need those things. They have those things. Why do they need a super state? And if they were going to have a super state, why not have an actual elected parliament instead of that fake one they pretend to have, which has no legislative authority whatsoever? Why not have a real president who's elected by an electoral college like ours? Why don't they do something to actually make it represent the people? Instead, they're just forcing them in together, smushing them up according to leftist, internationalist, socialist aims, and it is unraveling on them. It would unravel here if we were dumb enough to try to join with Mexico or something like that. The beauty of NAFTA, there's a lot wrong with NAFTA, but the beauty of NAFTA is it has none of those pretensions. It is just about trade. And one of the best things I see in all of this is the possibility of Britain joining NAFTA, because let me tell you, if you add Britain to it, you largely eliminate any chance that anyone's ever going to want to turn NAFTA into a super state. That will be dead. And having free trade with trading partners with mature economies where you're not going to bleed jobs to the other country, that's an entirely positive thing. So all of this could be very, very good for us.
Right. It also seems to me that this is just another artificial layer of government thrown upon the European nations.
It's horrifying. It's sort of the USSR without the gulag.
With that, J.D., I'll throw it back to you.
Rod, give me some of your highlights, and just talk about that meeting with evangelicals at the Trump Tower.
Well, you know, it was really great, and I have to say, I still am not a big fan of Donald Trump, at least not for president. I love The Apprentice. That was cool. And anybody who hasn't read The Art of the Deal should. It's a really good book. I read it decades ago. He's a neat guy, but, you know, I didn't really want him for president. I was Ted Cruz, you know. This is not my hope for us. However, it was a very interesting meeting. There was a very small meeting that wasn't really reported on. The big meeting went from supposedly being about 300 people to it ended up being about 1,000. It was really an interesting group. This is not the rah-rah session that Red State and some of those guys pretended it was. And I don't even know if any of those guys were present. It was a very thoughtful group. They were interested in being heard. They were interested in listening. They were not making huge demands, but they were seeking mutual understanding. I think some of that was achieved. Trump was as you've heard people say, when he isn't in character playing the guy who is on The Apprentice, he is much, much more humble and collected and thoughtful. You know, there's that word again. So I was reasonably impressed with that. It's obvious he doesn't speak evangelical as a first language. He may not speak it as a second or third language. On the other hand, I think the biggest takeaway for me, and it wasn't rooted in any particular thing he said, but rather a collection of them that kind of started linking up in my mind, was that he really does credit evangelicals for his victory. And if you think about that for a second, that makes sense, because he absolutely could not have won South Carolina in particular. And he probably would have been dead in the water right there if he had lost South Carolina. He couldn't have won down there without evangelicals. Now, you and I know that most of the evangelicals who voted for him don't go to church very often. It's a very different breed from the folks who were in that room last week. And yet, I don't think that Donald Trump makes that distinction very clearly. I'm not sure he understands that the way you and I do. So he looks at this room as the leaders of a lot of people who just handed him the nomination. And crucially, as we always think about November, but this is a man who plans long in advance. I think he's thinking about November of 2020. And I really believe, based on some of the things I heard, that he sees us as a necessary part of his coalition, and long and the short of it, to the degree that we serve his interests, not by being his servant, but in the sense of him thinking about this from his perspective, because we are necessary to him, I think there are some things we can absolutely get from him. And the one thing that just leaps off the page is judges. So let me talk about that just a second. He has, in fact, surrounded himself on judges with people from the Federalist Society and the Heritage Foundation. In fact, I don't know of a single person advising him on judges who isn't from the Federalist Society and the Heritage Foundation. That's remarkable to me. I'm not sure that George W. did that, and you've seen this on a number of things. On economics, his chief economics advisors right now are Art Laffer and Steve Moore and Larry Kudlow, and there's a growing group of foreign policy advisors that are old Reagan people. And so while I don't deeply trust this, because I really strongly want to stress that I don't believe this man is deeply ideological. I don't know if he's even read the Constitution. I don't have any idea where he would be if he were the only person making the decision in a vacuum. What I do know is what Morton Blackwell's always taught, which is personnel is policy. He's picking the right people. And he seems to think that we are essential to his coalition, which, by the way, we completely are. So those things being the case, why would he do us wrong on judges? And if we get the judges we need, honestly, that may be all we need out of this presidency. You saw that this week with the abortion ruling. You know, it's not just replacing Scalia. We got to replace some of these other guys who are about to retire. Kennedy's old, and he voted the wrong way on this 5-3 decision. And, you know, Ginsburg's going to go, and several of them may go. It is very possible that this next president could appoint 3 to 5 justices. And if that's Hillary Clinton, the Constitution's gone.
Hey, Rod, do you think that we can trust Donald Trump to make the right decisions when it comes to the Supreme Court? Get a feeling we can trust this man?
I don't necessarily. But I think what I just said, I came away from that thinking he really does think that this matters to us, and he really does think that we matter to him. This doesn't matter to him. Ergo, it costs him nothing to give it to us. That's what I think. I could be wrong, and I'm going to ponder that some more. But that was sort of my takeaway. Again, You know, we are important to his coalition. He can't get elected without us. Judges don't matter to him, from what I can tell, other than they matter right now politically, and they really matter to us. And he's looking at reelection. So, you know, he needs to stay on the reservation for 4 years, and I think he understands that better than maybe than we do.
Really good, Rod, and we are coming up against the end of our show. And, you know, and 25 million Christians did not vote last time, and he's sensitive to that. God bless you again, Rod. Look forward to having you back on the show. And I know we're down to the wire, Rick. Let's finish off.
Okay, J.D., I want to thank you for sitting in today as my co-host. I also want to thank our guests, Jim Corey, John Crane, our most recent guest, Rod Martin. I want to thank Mr. John Forsyth Jr. for working the boards. But for right now, we got to run. We got to go. Take care. God bless. And we'll see you tomorrow on the radio.